As we begin now looking at how to evaluate various machine learning algorithms, let's start back with KNN and look a little more closely at the sorts of solutions it provides. Let's start with our training data. And remember, we've got pairs of X and Y. So each one of these dots represents one training tuple. And I'm just making this data up, of course. Let's suppose we were going to query this KNN model over in this region, say right here at this point. Well, the nearest three, let's use k equals 3 here. The nearest three are going to be these. And remember, we take the mean of their value to get the value of, at that query point. So if we query from here all the way to about here, our model is going to take the mean y value of those. So the output of our model is going to look something like this. And notice it gives the same value at all these points. Eventually, as we query from left to right, we get to a point where this one gets dropped out and this one gets added in. And at that point, we'll have a sudden drop about like that in the model. And we continue on like this. We'll have another drop like that. If we query our model now from left to right in very, very tiny increments, we'll get a result that looks something like this. Note that indeed there are sort of jump points here. Some nice things about this are that it's not overfitting the data. In other words, it's not tagging each point. A negative aspect, though, is at the ends there, we have these, you know, horizontal lines that are no longer changing, or, you know, essentially this model is not able to extrapolate like we might if we had a parametric model.